We are going to start with unit number 7, methods of separation, day number 69. As I have told you earlier that chemists separate substances from each other to find out what is in them. So basically the main reason for separating things is to find out how these things are made and what are the substances that are present in a particular mixture or a solution. Scientists have discovered 4 methods that can be used to separate mixture. The first one is filtration that we have studied earlier. The second one is sedimentation and decantation. We are also done with this. Today we are going to study about and learn about a new method, that is evaporation. That how evaporation occurs and what is the procedure and what is the apparatus that is needed. Evaporation, page number 71. Evaporation is basically the process that is used to separate soluble solid particles, that is solute, from a liquid, that is solvent. It is used to separate solution, for example, mixture of salt and water. So basically in evaporation what happened is, evaporation is a method that is used to basically separate solutions. Because you know, when we make a solution, like if we take example of salt, or we take example of sugar, when we dissolve salt in water, we know that salt is soluble in water. It completely dissolves in water. That's why we call it soluble solid particles. So evaporation method is basically that a method that is used to separate solutions. If you have a solution of salt and water, you try the filtration and decantation method, but they cannot be separated. Solutions can only be separated through the process of evaporation. Filtration and decantation methods are used only when there are 2 substances that are not soluble in each other, like your solute is insoluble, like we take example of sand and water. Then if you have a mixture of something like sand and water or oil or water or something that does not dissolve in water, then you use filtration and decantation. But when you have something that dissolves in water, like you have sugar, you have food color, you have salt, then you use evaporation. So now if you look here, then this is the apparatus, the things that you need. First of all, you need a container. It can be your beaker, it can be your container in which you put the mixture of the solution of water and salt. This is your salt. This is your salt particles and this is your water. Then what you do, you put it on a tripod stand. This is your tripod stand and this is your Bunsen burner from which has flame in it. When you start burning, then you see that this water, it starts evaporating. It starts changing into vapors. It starts disappearing. You can look over here and you observe after some time what happens is that all the water, it evaporates and only the solid particles, the salt particles, these are left in the container. Because this is a method that you can use to separate solution, because the water evaporates and the solute, the salt, it remains over here. Now I am going to show you a video that I have made to explain you the process of evaporation. That is going to show you the step-by-step procedure and it will help you to understand the process of evaporation in detail. Now we are going to discuss a very interesting method of separating the mixture, that is known as evaporation. So a question here arises that how we are going to separate a mixture that contains salt. Filtration cannot be used to separate a solution that contains salt, because when you mix salt and water, then you get a clear solution. And for solution separation, filtration is not a method that we use. We use evaporation. That means that we are going to heat that thing, that solution that contains salt or something that is completely soluble, or if we can't heat that solution, we are just going to put it in direct sunlight for some time. So here we are going to perform that practical, that experiment. What we are going to do is, we are going to take this salt and we are just going to pour in water.
With the help of a stirrer, we are going to mix it to make a clear solution. If you keep on mixing it, then after some time you will see that the salt completely dissolves in water and you get a clear solution that does not have solute particles settling in the bottom. So we are just going to put it for some time. Here we can't burn it directly, so here we can use evaporation process. What I am going to do is I am going to just take a spirit lamp, and then I am going to put this tripod stand on it, and then I'm going to put this solution of salt and water and I'll let it evaporate. And this method can also be done by putting this solution in direct sunlight so that water can evaporate naturally, but here we are doing it artificially with the help of the spirit lamp, and we are just going to wait for some time, and after some time I'm going to show you that how the water evaporate and how the salt particles, they remain in the beaker, in your container, and in this way you can separate the solutions. The methods that I told you earlier, the three methods like filtration, decantation and sedimentation, and magnetic method of separation, these can be used to separate things that do not mix, that form a mixture, but the two substances that form a solution, they can be separated with help of this evaporation method. So you can see that the water is boiling and it is evaporating and it has reduced in the amount, and the salt particles, the salt, it is crystallizing. And now we are going to see further. So here you can see that almost all the water has evaporated, and if you look at this closer, then you can see that the salt particles over here, they remain, and the whole water, it has evaporated. So in this way you can separate the two solutions in which two substances completely dissolve, they are soluble, and this is all about evaporation.